Countfilms archives.
So yeah, thanks for having me, guys. I'm gonna show a lot of guard passing stuff today. So, anyone want to volunteer to get fucked up? Some of it won't be so bad, but some of it might be kind of bad. So, okay. So, guys, you also feel free to like stand
Thank
up, move
you.
Around, and get better angles. I don't do any like ceremony type shit, so you know, just walk around, you talk, and you can heckle me. It's all good. So, okay, go ahead, go down. So, I'm gonna start with some knee slice stuff. Okay, first I'm gonna talk about how to do a good entry. Okay, and then later on I'm gonna talk about how to really finish a good knee slice. Okay. So when I'm showing you guys all the entries, when you have you guys partner up and practice, I want you guys to try to avoid just like doing the old school finishes, you know, where, like you get all the way down to here. Like this is gonna be where I'm gonna have you guys stop a lot. Okay, like down with the underhook in a secure position. The problem is a lot of people like to try to like slide out right away. And if they don't know exactly what they're doing, like there's only certain times you're safe to do that, and they're gonna lose it a lot. Like you'll get past the legs, then he'll recompose. So just getting all the way down here and then chilling out, okay? So a couple rules when it comes to knee slicing, okay? I don't like to cut from the same side, okay? So like if I'm gonna be cutting to my left, I don't wanna be on the left side, okay? The problem is, even if I get this underhook and kind of get down, like you're always going to be dealing with a really strong knee shield if you're cutting on the same side that you're on. Okay, so we're going to do a lot of stuff to kind of like prevent the knee shield, and I'll talk later about how to deal with it if it does come in. But as a rule, just cutting from the proper side and having good mechanics, we don't have to deal with the knee shield too much. If I cut from the middle, okay, whether he's sitting up or he's on his back, if I can get out in front of his knee, it's okay. Okay, like here I could get down before the knee shield comes across and I can kind of get ahead of it. That's better, but the best time to knee slice is to, when you're going all the way across their body, okay? So like if I stepped in super deep, maybe he went de la hiva, maybe I just kind of load his hip up, like this would be a better time for me to cut because this knee shield has to come all the way across to the other side before it can get in my way again, okay? So the best time to cut is across the body, okay? Now, another thing about knee slicing in general is anytime he grabs my ankle, pretty much from anywhere, okay, there's an underhook available. Like if there's no underhook available, I'm not gonna go for the knee slice. I'll just do something else. So like if I stepped in here and he just put his arms behind his head, there's no underhook, okay? Well, now I'll come down and I'll do floating passes, I'll do leg weaves, like I'll just do some other pass that's set up, okay? So like if you guys are working on your knee slices and they're not giving you underhooks, you just have to do something else, okay? So crossbody knee slicing, okay? Anytime they're grabbing me, there's an underhook. Now, the way I like to step in, especially like, we'll talk about different entries too, like talk about if he's on his back versus if he's sitting up, because you'll do things a little bit differently. But we'll assume he's on his back right now. I'll get you guys going on like a good entry, okay? What I like to do is I like to step extremely deep with my shin into his knee. Okay, I don't step shallow because if you step shallow, he can kind of immediately turn your knee in, or you can immediately put a de la hiva hook in, and then I have to actually deal with a guard. Okay, I'm not really trying to step into de la hiva. I'm trying to step deep enough that I can actually push his knee towards his head a little bit. Okay, now he may be able to like out kind of pressure you and get back to a de la hiva, but the time he's doing that is the time I'm getting ready to set up my knee slice and go. Okay, and most people, when you step in really deep, the first thing they do is they grab your ankle. And again, if he's touching my ankle, I can honestly just blast through right now. Like the moment I feel contact would be the moment I would cut. Okay, so once I do step in, if I messed up and stepped in shallow and he grabbed my ankle, I might still go, but a lot of the time I'll step a little bit deeper, load this up a little bit more, and make sure I kill this hook all the way dead. Okay, if the hook does come in, okay, don't push the knee, because if you push the knee on someone flexible, all it does is kind of change the angle of the hook, okay? So like if he does start to put a hook in a little bit, I'm always gonna come back and use my palm and just push his actual shin down first. Once his shin is down, I can turn my knee on a little bit, the hook's not just gonna come right back in, now I can go back to dealing with his knee, okay? Now, when it comes to knee slicing, especially like, this is kind of like a diving knee slice, okay? I want to always let my knee go first, okay? Like, go ahead, just grab my ankle, okay? So, like, the first thing that moves on my body is always gonna be my knee, all right? And the angle I'm gonna cut at Okay, I'm always gonna try to shoot it up towards his shoulder, like I'm just gonna spin you. But honestly, as long as I don't cut out, it's okay. Okay, like sometimes you'll see me just kind of like drop my knee straight to the mat. Okay, that's a little more thudding. All right, most of the time what I'm trying to do is shoot my knee up towards his shoulder, okay, and just land where I don't have a lot of space between my knee and him. Okay, if I did land and there was a lot of space and I got all the way down, the first thing I would do would be line my knee back underneath me. Okay, like if I can feel my knee touching his ribs, I'm very stable. Like anytime you turn your knee out like this, like imagine if he was an ultra heavy and I turned my knee out, okay, that's when you're gonna get rolled, or that's when you're gonna make space for that knee shield to come back in. So in general, you just kind of plant. Yeah, you can come in there. He's like, okay, fuck this. So in general, like once I land, I always make sure it's lined up. Okay. Now, the way my knee goes, I shoot my knee really, really hard. Like, it's not just like I get it moving. I shoot it as hard as I can. Okay, because the tougher he is, the faster I have to get down. And the more, like, I can use the explosiveness to, like, kind of break the friction on my leg, where his grip is, and where his attachment point is over here. Okay, so the thing about that is I can't stay up. Okay, because my knee's going forward as hard as it is, I have to get down. So I have to corkscrew across. Okay, now this takes a little bit of practice to get comfortable with. It took me a while to get it down, but when I start to cut, okay, like my knee moves first, okay, I'm looking for my underhook already, I'm always gonna be coming across like this, okay? Now the reason I get down as fast as I do is if I stay up in the air like this, he says the knee shield's gonna come in, okay? Or if some guys are really incredibly flexible, they can kick up and over their head and get their foot back into play. If you stay up like this in the gi, like I'll just lasso you, and then the knee slice is gone, okay? So you have to shoot your knee as hard as you can, okay? And I have to commit to diving across. All right, I actually take my hand and I hit the mat. Like everything I've got, I'm catching myself with this left hand, okay? I'm going chest to shoulder, all right? And now this underhook that I'm digging, could I just turn a little bit here? It's really tempting to put this hand on the mat and kind of catch yourself with it. Don't do it. Anytime I'm planting like this right hand on the mat here, that's time he's gonna re-pummel me, okay? So like as soon as my hand gets anywhere near an underhook or anywhere near his shoulder, it has to be extremely sticky. Okay, and by sticky, I mean I'm actually taking this and I'm curling this up like this. Okay, I'm kind of taking my elbow and opening it up just a little bit. Okay, I'm pulling this down into my hip. Okay, and what this will look like mid-cut, sometimes it'll be me sitting him up to me. Okay, sometimes if they're bigger, or maybe I'm a little less stable as I'm coming down, it'll look like I accelerate myself down to him. Okay, like again, I'm just trying to get my chest connected to his shoulder where I have this underhook and I've got my knee lined up and I'm stable. Okay, and when I pull my elbow back like this, it makes it extremely difficult for him to put a knee shield in. Like if he tries to put it in right now, my elbow is just going to be able to kind of move it out of the way. So let's back up a little bit. So he's on his back. I step in. If I step in a little bit shallow like that, you can see I didn't load it up. It's still okay as long as my knee's not turned in. Okay, I just don't want to step. I don't want to deal with an actual guard. Like I don't want to let him have a De La Hiva where maybe he could go Kyle Terra or he can try to like invert to the matrix. Okay, so I want to step in decently deep. I just want to make sure this is dead. You see, automatically, if he's grabbing my ankle or touching my ankle at all, there's just room for me to get an underhook. Okay, now his leg positioning matters a little bit. I don't want this to come across and get in front of my knee here. Okay, because I could do like some of these folding pass type stuff, but I'm trying to look for a knee slice here. So what I'll do is I'll keep my hand on this knee down here when I start my cut, okay, and I'll open this up, right? And the way I'd open it up is I just come across and I just cup it, okay? Like even in the gi, I don't grab the gi here unless he's trying to grab my sleeve. I just cup it and I start to open this up, okay? That opening is me starting my cut, okay? And it's very, very important as when you start your cut, that especially from the De La Hiva, you keep your hand on this bottom knee. Because if I don't, Do I just grab my ankle? Like, if I just reach for the underhook right away and I start to cut, you see how it, his leg gets pulled with me and it like kind of pulls the knee shield into the way. Okay, and it's gonna be very difficult for me to get all the way down and get past this now. So just for the first millisecond of the cut, I have to keep my hand here. Do I just grab my ankle? Here, just that much, okay? It's not actually about the distance that I gain. It's just the first initial burst. I have to keep my hand there, all right? Now, once my knee starts to go, you can see I'm already kind of angling my hand from here into the underhook, okay? So it'll be hand, and then my forearm will lean on it as my knee is still going. I'm starting to fall across, and it's just kind of sliding up into the underhook, okay? And the better his grip on my ankle, the more it's gonna sit him up with me, okay? And that's gonna give me more space to look for that underhook, okay? Because if he's completely flat on the mat, I can still put my hand here and get the underhook, okay? But if you notice, it does sit him up a little bit, but I'm not letting the knee shield get in the way, right? Here, you see how his shoulder's off the mat now? That's me coming across and coming down. So, I'll do a couple of these fast, okay? I'll do a couple slow, and then I'm gonna kinda have you guys partner up and we're gonna work on this. We're gonna spend more time working on this entry than all of the rest of the stuff, because this is the hardest part. Okay. I step in. Like I said, if he doesn't grab me, I'm just going to do something else. All the way down. Okay. This foot can kind of just fuck off. It just does anything it needs to do. It's just an active post. If it posts out here, that's okay. Posts up over his head, it's okay. It's just for stability. Okay. Here. And if you ever land on their arm a little bit, maybe it was in the way, it's okay. As long as when I get down, I keep some kind of pressure here. Because I can always come back and move his arm out of the way. As long as I get stable first. Sorry. Just as an example, guys, like if that situation happened right there, where I step in, your arm's out like that, I'm just gonna start coming in for like a leg loop. And then if he starts to push me away, I'll start looking for underhooks to cut over the top and just do some kind of different pass. You notice my knee, the goal is always for my knee to move first. Yeah. And you notice I'm not trying to like pivot out, okay? I expect him to try to get quarter guard. That's okay. If he connects quarter guard here, like, yeah, go ahead. Here, especially if I'm down with my underhook, he's stuck. He's not going anywhere. He's better off like trying to kick over his head, trying to turn onto his stomach, kind of like force a scramble, then he is trying to hold a quarter guard. Here. So, quick recap, step in, okay, he grabs my ankle, I make sure the hook is dead, I make sure this is controlled, okay? Start to open this up, hand stays in the knee, my knee starts to go up towards his shoulder. As soon as it does, I can lean on this, start to come across, up into the underhook, falling across, slapping the mat. Okay. Guys, any questions on this entry real quick?
What if you think you're gonna get that underhook when you start, but he does something with his arm that stops you from getting it?
So like if I notice I'm gonna lose it mid cut. So it depends on how bad you mess this up. We're gonna talk about this a lot, like specifically in the seminar. But if I start to cut and I see I lost the underhook, I just take my hand across into the body here. Because then I can start to go around its head and go for a reverse body lock. But we're gonna, I consider stuff like that failed knee slice, and I'm gonna cover that really exhaustive, like extensively today. Guys, any other questions about the knee slice entry itself?
I got a question. Could y'all turn to where his head is this way and do it one more time? Sorry, just so people can see it the other way.
So here. You know, it's one quick burst, it's one smooth motion. We just wanna get down as fast as we can with the underhook still. Okay, guys, I'm gonna have you guys grab partners. Okay, don't fucking kill each other, all right? Because we do have a little bit of limited space. So we're gonna spend a decent amount of time working on this. I'm gonna be walking around trying to help everyone. If you guys have questions, make sure you get a hold of me, okay? You don't need to get overzealous quick.
Okay.
So if I get all the way down, it's over.
Okay.
So you're, you're doing this a little backwards. So you want to keep this pinned down. You want to open this one.
Okay. So this one's going to pin down?
Yeah. See, that was better. There you go. And I'm going to get my, I literally want to come down all the way chest. And then, ideally you want to lay like that. And then you just take your other foot and just post it wherever you need it to feel comfortable. All right.
And that's right.
Guys, don't try to go through in one go. Okay, don't try to get side control off of one cut. The goal is to get all the way down, and you almost want him to grab quarter guard. Okay, so when you get all the way down, you get your underhook, just chill out and don't try to pivot out. Don't try to go to side control. You're gonna make holes. And that's where they're gonna get their guard back. Okay, I'm gonna talk about finishing it really extensively, but just get down and chill out, okay? Yes.
Sorry, I know you just were up here. Any sort of threat or like how do you deal
gotta
with
block the, this first. You gotta
yeah,
block.
Sorry. Yep. So any potential threat from like deep like, trying to come underneath here?
Okay, and just nail a couple points home. So everyone's getting there a little bit better now. Okay, I know this is a weird knee slice at first because everyone learns how to do the old school 1940s like these knee slices. And it's not that those don't work, they just usually don't work. Okay. There's better ways to do it now. All right. So, again, keep in mind, guys, my hand is only on the knee for the initial burst at the very start. Okay. Like as soon as my knee gets going to where I want it to go, which is I'm not actually aiming for the top of his shoulder. I want my knee to be on the mat, close to his body. So honestly, anywhere from here all the way up to under his armpit, that's fine. As long as I'm not cutting out. When you cut out, you make space, and space is what's going to let a good opponent get their guard back. Okay. So my knee is just going from a straight line A to B. Okay, in one burst. If I do this without a partner, this is what it looks like. Like my knee goes extremely hard, and as soon as it starts to move, it's just going to where I want it to go. Okay, and I only need my hand there for that first little bit. Like as soon as that happens, you can see my fingers are just already angling to slide up into the underhook. Okay, so at that point I'm already trying to fall across. I don't keep my hand on this knee down here for any length of time at all, because if he were to get his hand on my hand here, now I'm going to have to be completely compromised. Okay, I don't want my arm to ever get close to going under my body. So it's like as soon as I start to open his hips here, start to cut, my hand's already going across. A lot of people are keeping their hand here too long and it's kind of making it awkward because they're not able to shoot their knee like they need to. Okay. And I lean on this knee. Like once I start to move, see I'm blocking it with my forearm, but I'm already angling into the underhook and I'm still coming down. Imagine my knee was still moving off the first initial momentum. Here. Now, hand placement is not super important, okay? It's important that I have some kind of cross angle, okay? Because I'm supposed to shoot my knee as hard as I can, and it's physically impossible for you to shoot your knee first as hard as you can and then somehow also have your upper body in front of your knee. Okay? So like you could shoot your knee and have it and be up above it, but again that's leaving too much space. He's gonna get his knee shielded or he's gonna lasso me. So you have to fall across. If you are finding yourself up here like this, that's how you know you didn't shoot your knee as hard as you're supposed to, because that literally should not be possible to do if you shot your knee as hard as you could. Okay, you have to come across. Okay, and the more I fuck my knee slice up, the more often you'll see me kind of posting above his head, okay? But that's because I didn't, like, sometimes the knee shield comes in a little bit, okay? Because I didn't bring a knee shield in a little bit, and you're kind of, like, correcting yourself around that, all right? But if you get going how you're supposed to, and you just shoot it, see, it's going to come across every time, here. And then again, a lot of people are posting their underhook hand on the mat. Okay, it's not that you can't get away from doing that for like a second, right? But something I would do if I were him on the bottom is try to get you to post this hand. Because when you post it, he can re-pummel it. I don't have any way to keep myself connected to him. Okay, the way you get re-pummeled on is you let him make space between your chest and his shoulder, or your shoulder and his shoulder. Okay, if I'm connected to this and I'm close, there's just no room for him to re-pummel me. Okay, so a couple of details to keep in mind. All right, and then a lot, everyone's doing this. Everyone's getting down and trying to circle out. The problem is, you see how much space I just made between my knee or my hip and his hip? He's gonna bring his knee in a lot of the time. Okay, it's not that you can't ever pivot out, but the times you would pivot out are the times where like you're really connected to them and you know you've got a lot of control. In general, I don't do it, okay? Because you don't want to be forced to have to circle his head. So like if I pivoted out, he started to bring his knee in, I'm gonna have to start coming around. And that's a lot of movement that's gonna give him an opportunity to get away. So we just want to land, we just want to plant. I honestly, I just want to be here, or I want to be here. So guys, just to go over a couple of details again, I'm gonna have you guys partner back up and keep going over it. Is there any questions real quick about this?
So if you land in the right place, your partner should have the opportunity to grab your quarter guard every time?
If I'm like in a live match, I won't give him the opportunity.
Right, right.
Because I'll clear his legs a lot quicker.
Right.
Okay. But I genuinely don't care if he catches me in quarter guard. And like I said, honestly, a lot of times if I'm going with wrestlers or I'm going with really scrambly people, I know as soon as he closes his legs on quarter guard, he's cemented himself in this position. There's no scrambling out of this, okay? This is the position, like, you should be able to stick this and finish without ever giving him an opportunity to get away.
Okay.
So, no, I don't worry about the quarter guard at all.
Right, I was just thinking about something to aim for when we're doing the drill.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. Let your leg trail behind, let him get you in quarter guard.
Yeah.
Because that's realistically what's going to happen a lot of the time, and it's not a big deal.
Okay.
And when he's in seated guard instead of like being in supine, how do you like to enter? Like
if he's sitting up, so this is gonna cover like a lot of different entries, but like I can step in and start to come across. You see I'm still gonna be doing that corkscrew motion, but the only difference is if he's sitting up to me like that, is you'll see me control their head a little bit, just because like I said, the only way he's gonna re-pummel me right now is if he gets space, okay? So the only reason I'm grabbing his head like this at all is, go ahead, re-pummel me. So he can't get the space to re-pummel it. You see what I mean? So, yeah, sitting up we do a little bit different entry, but the entry is still gonna be the same mechanics, where my knee's gonna go first, I'm gonna be leaning across, closing the space off so he can't bring a knee shield in, and then, I'm gonna talk about a couple of those specifically still. So. Any other questions, guys? Okay, go ahead, partner back up. We'll do a little more time on just getting this entry down, okay? I don't do the clap
thing. Okay. We
get
awkward.
We just run through it. I haven't done it from the Delahiva yet.
Yeah, I'm gonna get the DM online.
Well, it's on the daily dealer. Here.
It's 38 today.
Hey, that was good. That was good. Sometimes it's not a big deal. Sometimes if you let her push her away with it, then you'll lose the whole position. So if you do have the knee shield come in, double down.
Okay. Had a torn ACL, so it's kind of like not pushed out as much yet. Yeah, bro. No, it's good. But yeah, I know what you mean. Like, hold on to that arm. Yeah, this is it.
Yeah, I'll straight up shoulder crunch it. As long as I don't let her push me away with it, I can still deal with the show. You just can't lose the arm.
Oh, no, I did. So keep it tight.
And then
land with this foot posted out. Post it out so you're comfortable. Yeah. You don't want it to be very close to you, because then you will try to reach out your legs.
So
so I'm just saying, game, but like, this leg, is it better for my leg to be like back here?
No, I like to make sure that leg is under me. That way I know I have an angle cut through, and this isn't going to get in my way at all.
So is that like the right?
Like, with how wide he is right there, especially if you push the same angle a little bit down, use your hand instead of your knee. I don't want my knee to come over too much.
Okay.
But yeah, that would be a great time. Like, this would be a fantastic time to cut. Like, the wider his hips, you see how much easier it was to just go through? The wider his hips are, the better it is for you.
Okay.
Or you'll see me do stuff like I'll snap in the guillotine so it looks better. Because you can actually cut through a butterfly. Like, that's not a big deal as long as I have a good arm.
What are you doing for them not to like try to get into like some kind of.
You see how I can just stay in stable?
Yeah.
Well, the pressure's got to be here. Even if he went through and like grabbed under my leg, just, as long as I didn't lose this underhook.
Oh, okay.
You know, like, he might pull me the other side a little bit. And as long as I can just keep my heel under, it's okay.
Oh, okay.
And so even if you pull it like here, like you get these kind of positions where they do go deep half a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm just going to keep trying to reset the knee size.
You're moving your hips out to kind of snap your knee back.
Yeah, that's why it's important. Like, my knee angle gets adjusted by my hips.
That's why you don't turn out this way, right?
Yeah. Well, if I turn out like that, like I said, a big guy is just going to get his knee in, or he's going to roll you, or like there's exceptions. Obviously, like, something like this where I'm like super connected to you, that would be okay. But it's not as, you don't get as much pressure if you're holding quarter guard really strong.
Yeah. I was gonna ask about that.
If you've got knees planted and you don't check the part, you're not gonna go. Because you can always push to get yourself to here. Make sure you get your knee all the way to the mat.
Knee all the way to the mat.
There you go.
So I'm ending up here. I just need to commit a little more. My upper body.
You're perfect. Oh, you're perfect.
What?
That's very kind.
Don't let him keep that butterfly or that daily heat. Like, always take a little bit of effort to make sure the hook comes out from behind you first. Because it's just going to make it super awkward. It's going to be really easy for the track to get you. So, like, I'll kill the hook first, then cut.
Okay.
Yeah, not now you would cut.
And it's going to help me a little more to get to
my foot. Don't put your knee in. I'll bring your foot forward. Yeah. There you go.
It feels really powerful.
Is this in your first off?
Yes. Having a good knee slice is like 40% of one of these passes. Because knee deep passing is so loose, you need to have each one of those passes to keep you attached.
Okay. So you've got pretty much your whole system.
It's not only knee slices where you have to have a good knee slice.
But in that instructional, you have pretty much
your whole system. Oh, yeah. Everything's in there.
Okay, I'm probably just going to buy it. I need that.
Okay, guys, I've seen a lot better entries. Okay, now we're going to move on and we're going to start working on finishing it. Okay, this is the part that's going to suck. I'm going to preface this by saying, remember, whatever you do to your partner, they're going to fucking do to you back. So, okay. All right. You have a question? No. Oh, sorry. Okay, so we're making our assumptions here that I got all the way down and I got, like, my underhook, and I didn't get the knee shield in the way. Okay, like I said, we're going to troubleshoot what to do when we screw this up later, but we're assuming everything's kind of going okay at this point. Okay, and guys, everyone might want to come to, like, this side-ish. Let's get back a little. Okay, because you got to pay attention to what's going on with my knees a little bit here. Okay, so the way I'm going to talk about this is I only do as much as they make me do. Okay, so, like, there's different degrees of people being bad at jiu-jitsu. Okay, there's like the guy that doesn't even realize he just got knee sliced and he doesn't even try to close quarter guard. There's a guy that closes quarter guard, but he's just got his legs there. He's not actually squeezing and you can clear them without any effort. Okay, and then there's guys that death grip your foot like they're trying to rip it off. All right, so we've got different degrees of toughness and appropriate response. And I'm only gonna do, like, I'll escalate my pressure based on what he makes me do. Because, like, if I don't have to come all the way down and break his neck and fuck his hips up to get his legs to open, if I could just kick them open, I'm just gonna do that. It's a lot faster, it saves a lot of energy. Okay, so first things first, when I land across, okay, I make sure I've got my underhook. I don't want to get repummeled. A lot of this involves keeping my head pretty close to the bicep here. Okay, like if he did try to repummel me, like if I was like up in the air like that and I gave him space, that is just really bad. Okay, it's very difficult to get this underhook back. When you do lose it, we've got to do a lot of stuff to get it back. You might just lose the whole thing. So, even though when I first shoot, a lot of times my underhook is shallow, once I get down chest to chest, I'll take it and punch it deeper. Okay, and like I said, I'll keep my head in the area, so like I don't have to stay hugging it like this if he's not making me. If he's not contesting the underhook, I can be up in the air. But as soon as I feel him trying to repummel me, you see I'm almost kind of taking my hand up under my chin. In the gi, you can actually just grab your own gi and they basically can't repummel you. But no gi, you're just going to be kind of hugging it. Okay, using my head to direct it around, not giving him the space. Okay, and now the first thing I'll do is I'm going to check kick his legs. Okay, when I say kick, you know, you can't kick in jiu-jitsu, okay? What I really mean is push with authority, and then don't look at the ref afterwards, okay? Okay, like the difference between a kick and a push is just how white is your skin, okay? But it's here, all right? It's the drive. I want to drive through this, okay? I don't want to just kick it a bunch, because that won't do anything, okay? It'll just make him mad. All right. And the way you do this, guys, is like I'm assuming he has quarter guard. I'm going to come underneath that top leg and I'm going to push up to open it first. Okay. I just want to get my heel free, essentially. Like, even if all I did was just get this past my heel, like that, like go ahead, just clamp below my heel here, that'd be great. All right. And one of the things you do to make it a little easier is I just take my foot that's caught and I just point my toes. Okay. Because now, like I said, all he has is this little part of my heel caught. If I flare my foot like this, he's got my whole foot caught. Okay, so you're always gonna be pointing your toes a little bit. All right, I open this up here, and now before he can come back and close it, I'm just gonna move the bottom leg out of the way, okay? And now when I do that, it's very important I slap the mat with my foot. That way he can't just get back under my foot, okay? Like if I kept like on my toes here, kept my foot up like that, there's a good chance he'll get back underneath with his knee, okay, under my foot there. And he'll pull me back into quarter guard. But if I flatten my foot on the mat here, he could come over top and hook it all he wants. It's gonna be very hard for him to pull it back into anything. And I can always deal with this top leg being in the area just by kind of pushing it, okay? So at that point, once I've actually cleared his legs, okay, I can come down at any time, no matter where he puts this arm, and just kind of grab his tricep. Now I can come up a little bit. I don't like kesagatami as a position. I don't think it's the strongest position to hold side control from. It doesn't have the most options to like advance, okay? But it's okay to slide up here at this point when I'm connected and then use that to square myself up, okay? Basically, as soon as I clear his legs, go back, okay? Like the moment I actually clear these here, I just have to stay attached and squeeze them a little bit. I'm pulling my elbow into my knee here, so I'm getting a good cross pressure going. That way he can't shrimp out, or if he did shrimp a little bit, it would pull me with him. And like I said, now I can come up. I don't have to go kesagatami from here either. I can just open this up, and then I can square back up. Okay, then I can club his head and hold side control, however it is you like to hold it to advance. All right, but what I'm doing by kicking his legs, okay, I never compromise my position. Okay, a lot of those, like I said, the old school stuff where you're trying to slide out, you're really compromising your hips. You're really making a lot of space unless you're really mashing him off. When you're here and here and you just open him up and move him, he doesn't get the option to scramble anymore, okay? I always think if he's like a D1 wrestler and you let him turn into you at all and like even get close to wrestling up, like you know how hard it can be to hold those guys down? They don't get the option here, okay? And now what I meant earlier by like escalating pressure, okay, like if you assume he was just too tough, like squeeze the fuck out of my legs, okay? Like, you do want to put some decent amount of effort into trying to open that still, but if it's just not opening like that, then I'm going to come back, and I'm going to come across, start adding head pressure, knee pressure, clubbing his head, and you see I'll just start going down the line, okay, making it harder and harder for him to keep his legs closed. Then I'll kick him off, okay? And again, I'm saying kick, but yeah, everyone knows I mean push, right? Okay, so that's the first thing I'll do as soon as I land. If he didn't close quarter guard at all, okay, like his legs are still open because of the knee slice, you can just kick the bottom leg out of the way. Okay, and then you're good. As long as you keep your foot flat, okay, I've got this good underhook. So, I'll have you guys partner up. Remember, push this open. Okay, open it up, then push the bottom leg out of the way. Then I can control his arm, start to slide up, or I can control his arm and square up. All right? And then we won't spend a lot of time doing that because it's very simple. We'll come back and we'll start adding head pressure, okay? All right, as the reason I don't do the clap is my friend's had it too many times and I feel bad. So, guys, grab your partner.
Like, you would never do that.
See, that's gonna be very situational. You don't have to do that, though. Okay. You said the more I turn, the more space I'm making, usually.
Turn, I'm saying like,
yeah, so when you go to pivot out, if you look at, before you pivot, you can see how close your hip is to his hip. Mm-hmm. And then when you go to pivot, pause.
Like that?
Yeah, you see you're making a lot of space for shit to come in.
Okay.
Okay, so it's just cleaner to just move his body out of the way.
Okay, and then just stay there.
Yeah.
Like okay, I see what you're saying now.
You're still making it kind of, you're like doing a lot of big motions. And none of this has to be big.
Okay.
So like you're here, like I heal, move okay. This, just here stuff.
Okay.
Come down here. I don't have to take my legs back or small or
okay.
Do anything to make space at all.
Okay, I see what you're saying. So I'm sorry, I'm just dumb. I can't see what my bottom half is doing.
That's not what it is. It's just that like, everyone wants to do big motions.
Yeah. You do want to push both legs?
Yeah, I just move the bottom leg out of the way. You're a Casey guy, and Casey.
It's good for big guys.
Yeah, it is good for big guys.
Are you doing the arm crank thing? The arm lift space?
After I clear his legs. Yes.
After you clear his
before
legs.
I clear his legs, you lean on.
Okay, just stay to that shoulder. So it's.
Yeah. Push it open, then clear the foot.
Kick bottom?
Yep, push the bottom out of the way.
Slap.
Now you can post your left leg out, come under the arm. You can't get away.
Right.
That's
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
I was telling her this is what she was missing because she was letting my leg.
Yeah, I don't ever want to cut when that leg's across my head. Yeah. Like that, it's just going to make it really awkward.
So, like, as soon as I was stepping in, she was pushing it. And then you go here?
Yeah. Okay, guys, so we're gonna be doing the kicking off a lot, okay? I just wanna make sure everyone's on the same page on this. Now we're gonna move on. Okay, now this next part is the part that's gonna suck, okay? Because now you're gonna get your neck cranked on a little bit, you're gonna get stroked a little bit. All right, so now, like I said, I'm assuming I just couldn't get his legs to open at this point. Or maybe I could, but I'd have to put a lot more effort into it. I can soften him up a little bit first, okay? So what I'm gonna do, all right, I'm going to be going back and forth, guys, between using shoulder pressure and using my head, okay? I think using your head has a maximum, like a higher maximum pressure limit, okay? Like, I can do a lot more damage with my head. It's not as easy for me to do. Like, it's a lot simpler for me to just club his head and then start kicking his legs off, okay? But there's only so much pressure you can get with your shoulder, okay? And I can make it a really good choke, but... Again, I can add more pressure with my head and with my knee than I can with just my shoulder. Okay, so we're going to do the head pressure first. All right, so what I'm going to do, guys, is no matter what, okay, I'm always going to be able to get his head out of the way. All right, so like you'll see me sit people up from here a lot like this. This is always okay as long as I don't get repummeled. Okay, like again, I want to make sure this is being squeezed off. If I ever felt like he was starting to repummel me and I felt like I was starting to lose it, I can always take my other arm and start to just hug it in this X, okay? Kind of like the Gordon Ryan shoulder crunch. I'm just doing that from here, okay? Now I know he can't repummel me. Okay, but guys, it's okay for me to sit him all the way up. It's okay for me to even turn him on his stomach a little bit. He's not gonna get away from doing that, okay? Now, if he's doing something like tucking his head and being annoying and reaching under your legs and doing stuff like that, again, don't panic. You don't ever wanna have frantic energy from here. This is like consistent pressure, kind of grind him down place, okay? But I'm gonna end up trying to get my head on the other side of his head, okay? And if he's tucking his chin, tucking his head like he should be, okay, I'm just gonna come down and I'm going to start to cup on his arm, or I'm gonna start to cup his chin like this, okay? And you'll see me do some nudges, okay? I just wanna get this open to where I can get my shoulder on the other side of his chin here, okay? If I can get my shoulder there, I know I can get my head in the appropriate spot. Okay, and now is where we're gonna start to do some damage. Okay, if he was just sitting flat, I wouldn't have to worry about moving his head. I would just go from here to here. Okay, but a lot of times, like I said, I sit them up because it helps me make sure my hips are lined up. It helps me make sure everything's really secure in this underhook, and then I can really get a good cross face going. But I'm gonna put my head on the mat, okay, right against the base of his head. All right, now I wanna turn my head actually away from him. Okay, I don't want to use the side of my neck because you don't have a lot of pressure from there. Okay, I want to always be doing a neck bridge into his neck. Okay, now the trick with this, all right, is I'm going to let him move away from me first. Okay, so as soon as I start to push, you see how his whole body just kind of windshield wipered away from me? Okay, it's because I'm not putting any weight on my right hand. Okay, my right hand, that's the underhook, it's just, it may look like it's on the mat, but there's no weight on it. Okay, you might as well just have it like 1 inch off the mat. It's the same, okay? I just don't want to plant it yet. I want him to straighten out, right? So as soon as I push him, you see how he starts to straighten out? Now I plant the hand, okay? So now if I pushed into him, he doesn't go anywhere, okay? I'm going to readjust myself by stepping way out, okay? And you notice my knee's still lined up, right? This hand is your active post. It can go anywhere you need it to do to feel comfortable, okay? Now that I've straightened him out, now I plant my hand, and now I start to apply some pressure. You okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, assuming a quarter guard, go ahead. From here, once I start to put a decent amount of pressure, now I start to open this up. Okay. So we're softening him up so that we can push kick his legs open without him being able to hold it anymore. All right? It kind of sucks, right?
Yeah, that's awesome.
Like I said, this is the part where you keep in mind, if you don't want him cranking on your neck anymore, open your legs, okay? You do this all the time. You'll see like black belts, when you start cranking on their neck, they'll literally just open their legs, okay? Because they don't want you to break their neck. I feel like you could seriously hurt someone here, so don't do that, all right? Now, there's a weird situation where sometimes you're putting some pressure down, okay? And they lift their head off the mat trying to alleviate pressure, okay? If you ever can get your head, your neck actually behind his neck, it's really, really bad for him, okay? That's when I feel like I can literally break his neck here, okay? I'll actually go under it, plant, and lift. Then I'll kick it off. Yeah, that one sucks a lot.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be a lot gentler on the rest of these. I'm just kind of demonstrating, but...
Okay.
Okay. So again, think about his spinal alignment here. When he's curved into you, he's really comfortable, okay? And if I just go straight here and plant my hand, this'll suck a little bit, okay? But you can see he's still kind of arched into me. It's alleviating a lot of the pressure from him, right? So it's really important, guys, let him move first. Okay, straighten his spine out. Then you plant your hand so he can't move anymore. Readjust so I can push the power again. Okay, if I leave my foot back here, I can't really keep going. If I put it out here and readjust this way, I'm loading up to push in my neck hard. Now I start to put the pressure. Now I start to open this up, move this. And now once I'm clear, I don't need to crank on his neck anymore. I just need to control him. Okay, so then again, I'm coming to his shoulder, coming under his tricep, and I'm either gonna slide up, okay, or I'm just gonna square up. So, he gets ready to, okay. Again, seriously guys, I've taught this at a lot of different gyms. There's always someone in that's like stubborn. It's like, yeah, crank on my neck harder. Yeah, you only have one, okay? So, if you don't like it, let him pass, open your legs, okay? Don't be a sissy and just like open your legs for nothing, but don't let them just crank on you for no reason, all right? So, questions?
If he doesn't move, like, what's what you do then? You said don't move and let him move. What if he doesn't?
No, I force him to move. Okay. Like, I'm actually moving him out of the way with my head. Okay. Well, the only difference is, at the very start, I'm not putting any weight on my right hand. Okay, once I put my weight on it, he can't move anymore. Now he's getting pushed into my hand. So, I'm hover handing, like, you know, you're taking a picture with a hot girl, and you don't know if she wants you to touch her. So you're just like, your hand's like here instead of here. Okay, just do that. All right, any other questions, guys? Okay, go break some necks.
I keep forgetting this clap.
You clap. I didn't clap.
I'm just saying. I have no space for
that. I know. Put your arms around and
Oh, wait.